In this video, I'm going to show you some of the new features coming to a new version of WordPress to help you have your website be GDPR compliant. That's such a tongue twister. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. Click on the bell to not miss a thing. Let's just jump on into it. A new update is forthcoming for WordPress. It's going to be version 4.9.6, and it brings a couple new features that I'm going to show you. And I'm pretty excited and happy that WordPress came through for all of us WordPress users, and I'm going to show you that here in a moment. If you're not familiar with the GDPR, I'm going to leave a link to this article. I think out of all the articles I've read as it relates to WordPress and websites, this one I think is really good. It's one of the best out there. It's from Kinsta, who happens to be a WordPress host for more premium hosting. So I'll leave a link to this article down below. Essentially, most of you, unless you've been living under a rock, this is all you've been hearing about, and you've been receiving numerous emails from Twitter, from Facebook, from all these different companies saying we've updated our privacy policies. Essentially, two of the main cornerstones of the GDPR is you have to let someone know and get their permission whenever you collect personal identifiable information from them. This would be if someone left a comment on your WordPress website, they filled out a contact form on your WordPress website, or maybe even just ordered something with WooCommerce and now you're collecting their personal information. In addition to that, you need to have a mechanism in place if someone was to request a portable data format of all the information you've collected on them. You have to have a way of providing that, and you have to have a way of deleting all the information that you have on them, so you have to have that as well. Lastly, you also need to have a privacy policy that details out the ways of that you collect data, how long you store it for, and some other intricacies like that. And a lot of these problems are going to be solved, thank goodness, in this WordPress update. So I am downloaded the beta. It was just released yesterday. I don't recommend using it on a live site, but I'll just show you how this all works now in this video. So there's a new option here underneath. Well, there's a couple new options. Under tools, there's a new option that says export personal data and erase personal data. I'm going to show you the workflow of that. And underneath settings, there is a new option here that says privacy. So let's first take a look at that. So essentially, this is going to be a tool that will help you build a privacy policy. Now, I'm going to show you it right now. Actually, let's just jump to it. So what you could do is choose an existing page that you want to be your privacy policy, or click right here where it says create new page and create this new privacy policy page. And it doesn't do this for you. You're probably going to want to link this into a footer menu. So if your theme has a menu area in the footer, you're going to want to add a link to this to the footer for sure. So let's take a look at what this template looks like. So I'm going to click on, I think, use this page, and it's going to take me right on over to it. Let's see. Oh, here it is, letting you know to actually update your menus. That's actually very good. So here, let me click on edit. And this will show us what WordPress does to this privacy policy. Now, it's not like your typical template that you might have seen before, where you could just change the URL and the business name and you're good to go. It's not like that. There's a lot that you would actually need to change. So here is it right here. So everything in yellow is what you're going to want to look at, pay attention to, and change, because some of it has like this template-y stuff where you're just supposed to completely remove it and put your information in there. But it gives you a format or a framework for the sections of information that should be in your privacy policy, who we are, and then it gives you guidance on what to put there, what personal data we collect and why we collect it. It gives you some guidance there. And there's also little sections here that are not highlighted in yellow, and this is what WordPress has put there to stay there for you, to help you with some of the details of how WordPress fits into this privacy policy. So you can see right here under what personal data we collect and why we collect it, it leaves this paragraph for you to leave that says, if you're a registered user and upload images to the website, you should avoid uploading images with XF GPS data location included. So there's these little bits where it's adding information that you're definitely going to want in there. So next, here's some guidance on contact forms, on comments, and then here's two paragraphs that WordPress leaves in there for you that explains what happens when a comment is actually left, and it actually words it for you. The same thing here with cookies. So if you're wondering what cookies are involved with WordPress, well, it's actually written here for you. And here is as well embedded content on other website analytics. You got to change all that because it obviously doesn't know what analytics you have in there. Side note on analytics, Google has a feature to anonymize, if I'm pronouncing that right, the IP address. So then Google Analytics is mostly GDPR compliant. Who we share your data with? For most of us, it's going to be nobody, obviously. How long we retain your data, what rights you have over your data, and so there's a section here. Now, what you're going to want to do here is you are going to want to have a contact form on your website that people can use to request a copy of their information, and also the form will also give them the opportunity to request the removal of their information. So WordPress doesn't plug in a contact form for you with all that stuff. You're going to have to add that, but I'm sure you could put a administrative email address if you wanted to, and someone can just send the request to that if you wanted to do it that way. Okay, where we send your data, there's info here, your contact information, additional information. So this is going to be a great framework, and I'm probably going to go through this framework and fill it all out for me. And it also is kind of like a guiding framework for identifying where you, all the areas that you are collecting people's information. So this is part one of what the new update's going to do. Now, the second part is what I was showing you underneath tools. You can export personal data and erase personal data. And it's really cool how this works. So let me click on export personal data. So like I said a moment ago, you need to either provide an email address where people can send the request to, or if you already have a contact form, then on that contact form, people can request for their data and then also request for the removal of their data. And this is the workflow. Someone requests it from you, you now have their email address. Then what you do is you go in here, you take their email address or their WordPress username, you put it right here, and then you click on send request. And what that's going to do is it's going to send them an email to verify that actual email address, because someone can say, you know, send you a message and say, I want a copy of all my info and give you an email, and that might not be their real email. So you have to have this just process of verifying that that's their actual real email. Here's what that email will look like when they receive it. They're going to receive an email like this. It's going to say, a request has been made to perform the following action on your account, export personal data. To confirm this, please click on the following link. And then they're going to have to click on this link to confirm that that is really their email address. Then what happens is right here, you're going to see their request, and it's just going to say that they confirmed the email address. But then you actually have to come here and click on this button that's going to say send export link. So right now, WordPress doesn't do that part automatically for you, unfortunately, but I'm sure that might change. And it also, if someone confirms their email, it doesn't really notify you of that. And I'm wondering if it's that way on purpose, because you might also have information in other locations that you might want to add to this. Okay, so then you will manually have to come back here and click on send export link. And this is what that email is going to look like that they get right here. It's going to say your request. I don't know why they do this howdy thing. Is it that hard to just say, hey, Adam, or hey, so-and-so? Anyways, howdy. Your request for an export of personal data has been completed. So anyways, it's going to give them this link, and it lets them know this link is only going to be good for 3 days, and it'll tell them the exact date of which this gets expired and automatically deleted so that you're keeping their information safe. So all they do is they click on this, and it's going to download a zip file. Now, when they open up that zip file, this is what it's going to... Okay, so actually when they... I skipped a spot. When they click on that confirmation link in the prior email, I'm sorry. It takes them to this page where it's going to say action has been confirmed. So hopefully they give us a way of customizing this so it doesn't have to have the WordPress logo. Or maybe some of our page builders will give us more tools to customize this. I'm sure someone's going to have a way of doing it. Oh, and actually there's a link to the privacy policy. How cool. I didn't even notice that. Okay. Anyways, so when they click on this, it's going to download a zip file, and this is what the data is going to look like. So it says personal data export, and here's the information about this report, any comments that they've left. So I left a test comment on this website just to see if it would send me that information, and you can see it does. So you can see it collected my information, the browser I was using, my IP address, date and time, and the actual comment. It's all actually there. So it's going to show a list of comments. And then here's all the user information for the actual user account that is on the website. And it's real simple. It just has their email and their name and all that kind of stuff and the date that they actually registered. So at that point, you've done what your obligations are if this is all the information that you're collecting. You've already done your obligation, which is great. You go through the same process if someone wants their data deleted. The only difference is you don't go into the personal data. You go into the erase personal data right here, and it goes through that same process so someone can erase their personal data. There's a process in place where someone can have their personal data erased. Now, here's the exciting thing. This is coming to the core of WordPress, which essentially means that any plugin or theme is going to be able to hook into this functionality. So, for example, some of the learning management systems we use, LearnDash, LearnPress, what they're doing is they're going to hook into this. So when someone, if you're using one of those plugins, someone requests their data, it's going to show them their data from the learning management system as well. So you're going to, it's going to be so easy to fulfill these requests that people actually have that may want to see their personal data that you have on them. And I imagine all of the e-commerce platforms, WooCommerce, Easy Digital Downloads, they're going to as well have hook into this one way of doing it, so it's super simple for you. So of all of your plugins that might capture personal identifiable information on people, they're going to be able to update their plugins and just hook into this functionality. So what you need to do as the website owner is become a lot more simplified. You need to get your privacy policy in place. Whenever you collect someone's personal information, there needs to be an unchecked checkbox that says, by submitting this information, you're giving me permission to store your personal data, and you link to the privacy policy so that people can easily get to where you spell out what you do with that personal data. And so people will just have to check that box. So it'll be before they place an order, before they put a contact form, before they submit a comment, all of these ways where they could be giving information to you. You just have to have that checkbox, and it has to be unchecked. So once you're good with that, then you have a very clear way where someone can request their data or request their data to be deleted. And it's pretty simple. Obviously, there's third-party services that you need to take into consideration. There is a gray area as far as encryption of data. You do want to have HTTPS on your website. You want to do that anyway. But you also, there's that gray area. Do you have to encrypt where the data is stored on your hosting provider? And everything that I've read is you don't need to do that. But then wherever that data goes from backups should have some kind of an encryption in place. But you can read. This is not legal advice. This is not suggestions on anything. This is simply me showing you what is coming to WordPress very soon. And I'm sure a lot of the plugin authors where you're using their products, they're going to have blog posts and email updates going out saying how they're going to be hooking into this functionality. So you can expect that coming up. But definitely click on the link here to the Kinsta blog and you can read some of what they've put together. You really have to do... I'm not obviously getting into this information on who the GDPR applies to and all that. I can tell you for me, I am going to put the effort into putting a really good privacy policy together on my website, spelling everything out. I kind of like the transparency. I like letting people know everything that's going on. I'm totally cool with that. And I'll be adding the checkboxes where I need to add the checkboxes and all that. The only thing I'm a little resistant to is I do currently on my website track what people do on my website. Now, I don't want to have to, whenever someone new comes to my website, say, you know, do you authorize me to do this? I don't want that user experience on my website. So I'm personally debating whether I really do need to track what people do on my website, just the pages they're going to. I think it's actually unreasonable. My personal opinion is it's very unreasonable to force website owners to have to ask every single person that, when it could be safely assumed that anything you do on my website, I'm tracking what you're doing based upon your IP address. I don't, and in the United States where I am and where everything I do is, your IP address legally is not personally identifiable information. It's different in the EU. It's not that way in the US. That's the only thing that I'm struggling with. I don't want to have to annoy every person that comes to my website with that. But then again, I do want to be in full, absolute compliance with the GDPR. So we'll see what shakes down with that one for sure. So anyways, that is it for this video. I wanted to show you what's coming. So there's lots of other plugins out there that help you with GDPR, and that's all nice. I think I rather, it's just a WordPress problem, and I prefer the solution that WordPress is going to provide for it. I'm sure there's going to be maybe third-party plugins that enhance it, but I think this is probably going to work for most people, and this is definitely going to work for me. I'm glad that WordPress is taking it seriously. They put Gutenberg on the side to prioritize GDPR. I mean, bravo to WordPress for doing that. I'm so, and they're ahead of the game. Today's the 8th. On the 25th, this all goes into effect. So if they can get a couple rounds of beta testing and get this out there in 10 days, they're still ahead of the curve. Give everybody a week to put their privacy policy together. Anyways, that's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching this video. I'll probably have some more stuff coming out on the GDPR. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.